Hey guys, so let's see that example on Proteus simulator, working example. So this is the code we have designed, how to read the data from a slave using I2C protocol and how to write the data to the slave using I2C protocol. So you have to design the code yourself, because I have explained all the topics related to this code, each and every step, how to communicate, in my previous post. You can go through them and you can check. Okay, so let's begin to the working model. So now it's a design. We have designed this on simulator. This is our master, our 8051 controller. This is DS1307, that is real-time clock RTC. It will act as a slave, and the mode of communication which we need to communicate with this RTC or with this slave is I2C. This is two wire. This is SCL, serial clock, and SDA, serial data access. So we have connected this to these two ports. After that, whatever the data we are going to receive from this slave, or you can say master will receive the data from slave, we will display it on this LCD so that we can check whether our program is working or not. So in this program, I have created two switches. This switch is used to write the data in this one, in this slave. So by this switch, master will read the data from the slave. So let's begin. So this is I2C protocol communication by Salah Tutorials. Now you can see here the current date and time. The current data in the slave is it's 12:31:15, 4th January 2019. Okay. So now this is the current data. The LCD is blank. Now we have to decide, we have to read the data or we have to write the data. Let's read the data first, whatever the data. So reading data via I2C from slave, and you can see, okay, so the time is 12:31:33. At this point of time, master reads the data from the slave. So now once again, if you want to read, now the time is 41 seconds. So now again, if you want to read, it is reading the data, and now the time is in which 46 seconds. Here it's 48. So just 2 seconds back, it read the data from the slave. So now if you want to write the data, just press this one. So writing data via I2C to slave. Now you can see data changed. 00001, it is continuing because it's RTC. So it has hits on clock pulse. It is going to increase. So now if you want to read the data, you will get the updated data what is saved in that slave. So now the data we have received is, it's 00001515 seconds, date is 1st January 1989. So it's 24. Again you want to write the data, again it will set whatever the data we have set to save. Now again it is starts from the starting. Now if you want to read the data, so it is again reading. So whatever the data you are saving, we are reading that. So we have designed two different functions. By pressing this switch, master will write the data in the slave, and by switching the read switch, master will read the data from the slave. Yeah, if you want to read the continuous time, so what you can do is, let's stop this one, let's do some modification. So what we are going to do is, in our main, so we are not going to use this read function. Let me comment this one, and simply I can write read date and time. So I am reading data and I am continuously in while loop. So let me create the hex file now. Let me run this. So again, the current time is 12:34:05 seconds. Now it is continuously reading the data, as we are not, now this switch will not work because we have commented this code, and now we have put it in a continuous loop, or you can say infinite loop. So now that it is reading, master is reading the data continuously. Now if you want to write the data, it is writing the, see the difference. Now the new data has been written. Now it is reading the new data. So it's 4, 5, 6. So let wait for 2 or 3 seconds. Again we will write the data and then observe. We have written the data. Now it will again start from the initial data again. So hope you understand this, how to communicate with slave, or how the communication takes place between master and slave using I2C protocol. So if you have any doubt, please you can post your doubts in the comments. I will try to clear them. Thank you.